It's March 20, 2024. We're here at the World Health Organization with Ellen Tahone. And Ellen, I'd like you to introduce yourself, tell people who you represent, why you decided to come to Geneva this week, how you think the negotiations here are going, and what advice would you like to give to the negotiators?
My name is Ellen Hoen. I am the Director of Medicines, Law and Policy. We are a research and advocacy group that works on issues related to access to medicines, vaccines, medical technologies, and intellectual property, access to know-how, access to technology. And I have come to Geneva this week for the INB9, which was planned to be the last 2 weeks of negotiations for the World Health Organization's pandemic accord. The decision to negotiate such a pandemic accord is very much in response to the grave inequities that were so painfully apparent during the COVID-19 pandemic, and find a solution before the next pandemic hits, so that issues such as lack of access to products, lack of access to the know-how to produce these products, lack of equitable distribution of products would not happen the next time around. We've seen several drafts of the text of what could be the pandemic accord over the last year or so. Some have been better than others, but what is a little worrisome is that at the beginning of this round of negotiation, it became clear that there was actually very little agreement about the text that is on the table today. At the opening plenary, I said that we thought that what we were presented with was an improvement over the previous text. The text had tightened. There were clearer commitments in there, clearer commitments with regard to the sharing of intellectual property, with regard to sharing of know-how, clearer commitments to sharing of government-funded innovations, a number of issues that are often contentious, but were much clearer worded. What is still missing, a number of things are missing, but one thing that is close to our heart is a provision to compel the disclosure or the sharing of undisclosed information when it's necessary to produce pandemic countermeasures. Much of the text still leans on voluntary measures, and that is wonderful if it works, but if it doesn't work, governments need to be able to intervene. They can do that with regard to patents, through use of compulsory licensing, for example, and a variety of other exceptions and limitations to patent right, but with regard to know-how, you need to actually create a clear commitment that countries will make sure that they have such provisions in order to make sure that globally know-how is available when necessary. So that's also one of the reasons why I'm here, to advocate for that and to explain why that is important. Now, my advice to the negotiators at this point in the negotiations it's still a question whether real negotiations are going on. As far as I understand, they are documenting the disagreements, but there isn't a back and forth taking place yet to resolve those. My advice would be to have dedicated groups working on the difficult articles, which are the articles related to research and development, to a pathogen and access to benefit sharing, and the chapter that is Article 11 on technology transfer. And I would focus on those, because my sense is that if you would have an agreement or even a level of agreement on those difficult subjects, other things will fall in place. That is not happening, and time is running out. So I expect we will be back in Geneva at some point before the World Health Assembly. But let me take a positive view at least they're talking, and things are moving forward. And we are here to help delegations who want to know more about the issues that we have expertise in.
Thank you very much, Alan.